Who is the greatest swimmer of all time? Is it the 23-time Olympic gold medalist, 5-time Olympic legend, the Baltimore Bullet, Michael Phelps, or the rising star from Florida, the fastest swimmer in the world, Caleb Dressel? Their performances in the pool are absolutely incredible. They've become global sports icons, and in this video, we're gonna put them head to head. We're gonna look at the stats, analyze their technique, and by the end of the video, I'll share my thoughts on who is the greatest swimmer of all time, Caleb Dressel or Michael Phelps. As of the recording of this video, there is no question that Caleb Dressel is the fastest freestyle and butterfly swimmer that the world has ever seen. He holds the US Open record in the 100 butterfly, in the 25-yard pool. He has the world record in the 25-meter version of the 100 fly, and he broke Michael Phelps' world record in the long course 100-meter butterfly in a 49.5. On top of that, Caleb Dressel holds the world record in the 50-meter freestyle, and in 2018 at the NCAA Championships, Caleb Dressel swam a 17.63 in the 50-yard freestyle, winning by over a full second. That is just nuts. Can someone check gills on this guy? No, but really, he's a super chill guy, very humble. And if you want to see an interview I did with Caleb Dressel, where we talk about his training schedule, how he sets his goals, make sure you check it out, linked in the description below. As great as Caleb Dressel is, let's not lose sight of Michael Phelps' very impressive resume. He went to 5 Olympic Games, but he didn't just make an appearance, he destroyed the competition, winning 28 Olympic medals, 23 of them gold. His most impressive Olympics came in 2008 in Beijing, where he won 8 out of 8 events. That's right, he won every single race. Not only did he win, most of those swims were a world record. Not only did Michael Phelps cap off an impressive career at the 2016 Rio Olympics, but he's won dozens upon dozens of world championship medals. Now that you've had a little bit of context on these two superstars, let's dive into some details. And to start, a little bit more information on these guys. So we've got Michael Phelps and Caleb Dressel. The Baltimore Bullet was born June 30th of 1985. And then we've got his Florida Gator is Caleb Dressel. He was born August 16th, 1996. Both of these guys in the last millennium. Now Michael Phelps stands at 6'4" tall. For our metric friends, that's about 1.93 meters. And Caleb Dressel is 6'3", so just a little bit shorter. Now, both of these guys are at 195 pounds. That's about 88 kilograms, I'm sorry. And Michael Phelps has gone to 5 Olympic Games. Caleb Dressel has gone to 1 Olympic Games. Michael Phelps, 28 medals. And we've got Caleb Dressel with 1 medal. They actually swam on the relay together in the 2016 Rio Olympics. How special was that? Michael Phelps' 5th Olympic Games, Caleb Dressel's 1st. They swam together on the 4x100 freestyle relay. Now, Michael Phelps has a total of 28 medals, 23 of them gold. And in terms of world championship medals, Michael Phelps has 82 total international medals. 34 of them are from the world championships. Now, Caleb Dressel has a number of international medals as well, 24 world championship medals. In fact, in the 2017 world championships in Budapest, Hungary, he was 7 for 7 in gold medals. And I believe in one night, within 1 hour, he won 3 gold medals. And that's when a lot of the comparisons between Caleb Dressel and Michael Phelps started to emerge. Now, we're gonna go ahead and skip on to the next slide, and we're gonna talk about best times. So let's go ahead and talk about the 100 meter butterfly. This is the cream de la creme of Michael Phelps. He started with a 200 butterfly in the 2000 Olympics back in Sydney, where he qualified the 200 fly. In the 100 fly, Michael Phelps' best time is a 49.82. Now, this was the world record in the super suits in 2009 World Championships in Rome. Big drama behind him and Milorad Kavic. It was absolutely insane. And Caleb Dressel actually just recently broke this world record with a 49.5. 5-0. That is absolutely clocking, and he destroyed the field when he went that. When we look at the 100-meter freestyle, that's another event that these guys overlap in. For the 100-meter freestyle, now, Michael Phelps actually did not compete in this event in an individual race, but he led off the freestyle relay all the time. And his best time is back in the 2008 Olympics in Beijing. He went a 47.51 leading off that relay. If you remember, Jason Lezak anchored with a 46.06 split to take the lead away from the French, and the U.S. won, and that's how Phelps was able to win those 8 gold medals with the help of his teammates. And Caleb Dressel's best time is a 46.96. He did that at the World Championships just a couple of years ago. So as you can see, just by looking at the times, it's really close, but Caleb Dressel's just a little bit faster. Now, this doesn't really tell the full picture, because Michael Phelps's best events are actually not the butterfly. I mean, he's good at pretty much everything, but really the individual medleys. So let's take a look at that 200 individual medley, an event that he won in multiple Olympics back to back. So his 200 IM time is a 154.23. That is flying, and that is in long course meters. All these times right now are long course meters. Now, we don't have a best time for Caleb Dressel in this specific event. However, we do have some times in short course yards. In 2018, I believe at the SEC Championships, Caleb Dressel swam a 1:38.23. That is absolutely ridiculous, and most would argue that would be on par with a 154 or 155. So you're gonna have to do your own comparisons there if you swim in short course yards, or maybe you've looked at these times and you can do your own analysis on that, but it's really difficult to say, but we'll put those numbers out there. Now, what about the 200 freestyle? I think that's fair to put in there. What if we talk about 200 free? Now, Michael Phelps' best time in this event from the Beijing Olympics was a 142.96. Now, Caleb Dressel has, I believe it may be 146 or 147 is his best time in this event, but I would argue if his time's a 46.96, he can swim the 200 IM. He's not gonna die. He would obviously have a lot of front-end speed. I would put him in the 143 territory. Now, he hasn't gone that time officially, but similarly, I would say he's in that 142 to 144 range. 144, no problem. I don't know if he could dip into 143, 142 territory, but if he swims it, that's where I think he would be at. And then in terms of the 400 IM, this is arguably Michael Phelps's best event that he went in Beijing. He went a 403.8. Sorry if the numbers are getting cut off there. We do not have a time for Caleb Dressel. You might be able to guess maybe he'd be under 410 in this event if he were to swim it. I'd say he'd be under 410. He wouldn't really swim it in international competition. If he were to swim it in yards, I definitely think he would give Michael Phelps his best time, or Chase Kalish, whoever has the record right now, a run for their money. So that's where we're at in terms of times. Now let's look at the stroke, and I have a freestyle stroke of Caleb Dressel right now. And, you know, they do a lot of things very similarly. I'm going to show Michael Phelps right after this. If you guys want to see a full analysis I've done on both Michael Phelps and Caleb Dressel in both butterfly and freestyle, those are unique videos on this channel. So make sure you check them out if you're interested. One thing I want to call to attention here is this rhythmic breathing that they have. So they breathe every 2 strokes for the most part. And Michael Phelps was notorious for having this galloping stroke. And I think Michael Phelps and Caleb Dressel share that characteristic. They both also have a very leg and hip driven stroke. So there's a lot of rotation happening, a lot of power is coming from the legs. The difference really, and I'm just gonna go ahead and play this actually in slow motion, that'll make it easier. And I'll just commentate as he's swimming. So he's got a really high elbow position, a little bit of a crossover actually, if you see the head position where the hands are entering, a little bit of a crossover. He could probably be a little bit wider, but he's got that galloping stroke. He's doing rhythmic breathing, and that allows him to maintain his tempo and his pace through every point of the race. And this is something that's very similar between Caleb Dressel and Michael Phelps, that rhythmic, gallopy type of stroke. And here comes the turns. Dressel right there, absolutely killing it underwater, staying underwater longer than everyone. And this is something that Michael Phelps actually brought to the media, because people before, they have never seen someone go 5, 6, 7, 8 dolphin kicks off of every single wall like Michael Phelps did in the longer races. And Caleb Dressel is definitely cream of the crop in terms of speed. Now here's Michael Phelps's stroke. You can see that underwater motion right there. It's beautiful, starting out every single length, every push off the wall with that undulation. There it is, like that, good streamline. Definitely very consistent. Michael was very consistent. And here's his freestyle stroke. We don't want to miss it. So you can see just a little bit, Michael Phelps definitely has a more textbook freestyle stroke. It's a little bit cleaner than Caleb Dressel's. Caleb Dressel is a little bit more, you know, thrash. You can just see the elbow position right there, super high elbow. If you guys are wondering why that's important, you always wanna have your elbow above your hand, both above and below the water, because when you think about it in freestyle, when you stick your fingertips in the water and you extend right in front of the shoulder, you wanna bring your fingertips down as you start to initiate that early vertical forearm. I talk about this a lot in terms of instructional technique here. Early vertical forearm is EVF, and basically you want to be pulling the water with not just your hand, but also your forearm and your entire arm. And if you look right here at where the hand is and where the elbow is always above the hand. Michael Phelps is textbook freestyle, and he does this at every single speed, whether he's swimming a 400 freestyle, a 200 freestyle, or a 100 freestyle. It's beautiful. Look at that. Wow, what a work of art. Oh, and here's some butterfly. Butterfly, definitely Michael Phelps and Caleb Dressel swim a little bit differently. I did do breakdowns, dedicated videos on each of those strokes, but it's really a thing of beauty to watch. And Michael Phelps, Caleb Dressel, these guys are legends in their own right. I mean, if we want to just break it down in terms of like physique and intimidation, I mean, you could say Caleb Dressel's got the baby face, but he's also got these sick tattoos. Look at that. That's amazing. What does Michael Phelps have to say about that? Michael Phelps has certainly more hardware. They're both jacked. He's got some tattoos as well. But these guys are studs in their own right. And I hope you guys enjoyed this analysis. So what do you guys think? Again, let me know in the comments below. In terms of Olympic accolades, I mean, hands down, Michael Phelps wins this. You can't really argue with 28 Olympic medals, 23 of them gold. Remember, they grew up in slightly different eras, even though they did share an Olympic Games in 2016. On the flip side, if we look at this from a time perspective, one race for each of these athletes stands out to me. So for Caleb Dressel, it's his 17.63 50 freestyle he did in 2018 at the NCAA Championships. This is 4.67% faster than anyone else has ever gone. Cesar Cielo went 18.4 way back in 2008, I think. He has the current world record at the time of this video in the long course 50 freestyle. That was with the super suits, of course. But, you know, 4.5% faster than the next fastest human being is ridiculous in any measure of elite sports or elite anything. For Michael Phelps, it's his 403.84 400 IM that he went in Beijing. Now, the next fastest competitor was Ryan Lochte, and I believe he won a 405 in the following Olympics, because Phelps went that in 2008. But that's only a 0.5% improvement over the next fastest swimmer. So in terms of Olympic accolades and, you know, the mainstream media, you know, greatest of all time, that's still Michael Phelps. There's no question about that. Let me know what you guys, if you guys disagree with me in the comments. In terms of absolute performance, you know, some of the swims that Caleb Dressel has been able to put together, not just that 17.6 50 free, but his, you know, 100 butterfly in long course and short course, as well as his 100 IM that he went pretty recently with a 49.2. I mean, no one is even close to that, you know, but there's something to say about consistency. When you dominate the sport for nearly two decades, you got to remember, Michael Phelps broke his first world record back in 2001, I believe, and he was only 15, or 2000, and he was 15 years old. He was a boy swimming among men. I'm so lucky to have met both of these guys over the years. They truly are incredible. So let me know what you guys think. Who has the better technique? Who's the best all-around swimmer? Let me know what you guys think in the comments of this video, and be sure to follow MySwimPro on all of our different social media channels for more content like this. If you want to check out my new book called Swim Like a Pro, I'll make sure that's available linked in the description below. And also check out the MySwimPro app, available for iOS and Android. And finally, make sure you join the MySwimPro Facebook group. We have thousands of swimmers from over 100 different countries who are all passionate about swimming faster and smarter than ever before. So you can meet them, be inspired by them, and make sure you can engage with the community. Use the hashtag MySwimPro. I wish you guys the very best, and happy swimming.